Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to a special episode of the Poncho section. Today is our pre-game Super Bowl episode, and by the time you listen to this, it'll be after the game, so let us know if we were correct with our guesses. Yeah. This episode is... Thank you. This episode, warning, is not appropriate for children or Patriots fans, so please enjoy.
Well, when have our episodes ever really been appropriate for children?
I think Patriots fans.
Yeah, that's true too. I think from this point forward, if you have any children who might be listening, shut it off because they shouldn't be listening to any of our episodes.
Yeah, that's probably smart.
Yeah. So we're live at the time here in Long Island. We're
yes.
out in Bayshore, Long Island at our
good friend
Rando's house.
Woo!
Rando! What's up, world?
Dave. And, yeah, so we kind of decided this sort of last minute that
yeah.
we wanted to do a... Even though this was going to come out, this has come out after the Super Bowl, we still wanted to do our predictions
yes.
to see if anything was accurate. And we had some crazy ideas we were talking about earlier today
yeah.
about possibly Roger Goodell stepping down as commissioner of the NFL after he hands Tom Brady the trophy.
God, I hope so, because he's a piece of crap.
That would be the only good way for the Patriots to win. Like, if they win, it's like, oh, they won. But, and then Roger Goodell gets to...
You look like you want to say something.
The only good thing that could come is if Roger Goodell steps down and Tom Brady simultaneously retires.
And he cries, and Jerry Jones is there somehow, and he's
also
crying. That would be perfect for me as a Giant.
And Johnny Manziel becomes the new quarterback of the Patriots.
No, fuck that. I hate that.
That dude's
terrible.
That dude does like blow and then punches a girlfriend. He's got issues. No,
yeah.
But I literally do not want the Patriots to win the Super Bowl because there's no quarterback that has more than 4 Super Bowl rings. Joe Montana has 4. Terry Bradshaw has 4. Tom Brady has 4. If Tom Brady gets the 5th ring, that means he is the greatest of all time, and I do not...
Gets the middle finger, too.
I do not... want to have to deal with Patriots fans. By the way, world, Poncho section, this is their friend Andrew.
Yeah, yes. We should make this a little clearer for everybody
right.
for who's talking.
Hopefully
they recognize our voices.
I would hope so.
Sorry.
I'm Ethan.
I'm Michael.
I'm sorry. This is Andrew.
A.K.A. Google.
Everyone else calls me Google in this group, but in the music world, who knows Grau. You can follow me on all of my many food blogs and... music blogs, just search the name Grau, it's fine.
We don't do promotions.
Yeah, what the fuck are
just,
you doing,
just kidding,
dude?
Just go for it.
Rude.
By the way, my GoFundMe page.
No, I've actually thought about doing a GoFundMe page to be like, to just kind of like, you know what, I really want to pick up like a cocaine addiction, so like, just like, fund me like a couple $1,000 and want to see what's going to happen with that. But,
well, that
know.
Won't get you very far.
Yeah, like, why not, 50 bags, 50 bags are alright. You can get like 50 bags and get like, you know. I shouldn't know this much about cocaine, I'm sorry. But my
football.
So I want to talk about the announcers.
Yeah.
Talk about Joe Buck and
Joe,
Drake. And what do
fuck
we got,
Buck.
What do we think about
fuck.
What do we think about Fox having the Super Bowl this year?
It's gonna be a blast.
Yeah, see,
this is my
Fox to me is the biggest disappointment. Actually, you know what? I shouldn't say that. CBS is pretty bad, too, because Phil Simms is pretty terrible at this point. Because
he was a former Giant.
No, that's not true. I mean, it is true that he was a former Giant, but it's not true. That's why. He's just very... I don't know. He's not interesting.
He's very white.
There's a Twitter account, and I might have mentioned this before. There's a Twitter account where it's Phil Simms quotes. It's just called Phil Simms quotes, and they're just real quotes he said. And there's nothing else.
It's just
goes to show you, like, this is these are actual things he says.
Yeah.
See, I this is my impression of Joe Buck and Troy Aikman announcing this game.
And my name's Joe Buck, and they ran the football. I'm Troy Aikman. I played for the Cowboys in the 90s.
That's gonna be it. And I don't want
to
hear that.
How many times do you think Joe Buck will be forced to smile?
Yeah, we'll
7.
See that. He's the last few games he hasn't looked happy because I always do that game with friends where he will look at he'll look at Troy Aikman
mm-hmm.
and then he'll look back at the camera and he gives a smile. And every time he does that, you take a drink. You know, that's a drink. But he hasn't done that. He's been looking and he's been looking kind of sad. And I'm wondering if something's going on with Joe Buck.
Maybe Troy does not reciprocate his love.
Maybe.
I was going to say, do you think there's trouble in paradise between the two commentators, you know?
I don't know. I think, you know, it could be, you know, his personal life. I'm not really sure. I know he had his autobiography. Didn't that just come out? Maybe it's not selling as well as he thought.
I don't know. I don't think you're allowed to have an autobiography like until you're really, really, really old. Like if I did an autobiography like
where's that? is that a rule?
Like if I was like 80 and I wrote an autobiography, I feel like that would be fine. Whereas like when you're like in your 50s, it's like, yeah, tomorrow I'm gonna wake up and eat grapefruits.
Yeah,
like,
don't
fuck.
By the time you're eight in your 80s, don't you forget a lot of this stuff and like lose a lot of details?
Well, I'm hoping I don't have dementia.
I'm not saying dementia. I'm not saying you forget who you are. I'm just saying you forget a lot of the main details of the stories.
Listen, I always have a bunch of interesting stories I always bring to the group because you know I have a weird life. But I'm always like, I never forget them because I'm like, this is going to go in the biography. Not even autobiography, because I'm not writing myself. I can't write.
I don't know, but granted, this isn't the, what is it, the bar, but I'm pretty sure Justin Bieber has an autobiography.
Really?
Well, my life was so hard in Canada, and now I'm famous.
If you have a story to tell, yeah. I think it doesn't matter what age you are.
No.
Andre Agassi came out with his autobiography.
Really?
He was 40.
Yeah. At what
and
point?
He had a very interesting story to tell.
Yeah, but he was also retired, though.
Retired from his sport that you retire at like 35.
So are you saying you shouldn't retire till you're 80?
I'm not playing on it.
Well,
I'm not going to stop playing music.
Anyway, autobiographies, you know, that's we can do a whole nother episode
yeah.
on autobiographies.
Going back to
and whether,
sorry.
And whether...
Sorry, I'm the worst around.
No,
them,
it's
sorry.
Fine.
Did you
I'm
see
sorry.
That freeze frame of Troy Aikman? Where he looks like spot on, like the white imposter of Jay-Z.
Oh, yeah.
That's been going around.
Yeah. Oh my god, it was like.
So wait, actual predictions. Actual predictions.
Yeah, yeah.
I predict that Tom Brady is going to come into this game super cocky because he's like, this defense sucks, blah, 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 and he's going to get blown out like he did with the Giants both times. I feel like the Atlanta has a way better offense than the Patriots offense. Patriots offense is used to a certain amount of like what they can do, but Julio Jones is going to be the MVP of this game, and I feel like the defense for Atlanta is going to step it up, and they're going to make Brady uncomfortable. They're going to be able to run, but they're not going to be able to pass that well, and it's going to be like 42-35 Atlanta.
42-35 Atlanta.
That
would be
from
a nice high scoring.
Okay.
That's
exciting
what I'm saying.
Game.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
As long as Tom Brady loses.
42-35. That's okay. That'll be
because it's literally gonna.
How'd you get there?
Even the Patriots.
42-35.
The Patriots are not that good at defense.
Their
so it's,
defense is surprisingly.
It's not even top. It's not even. It's like four. It's like four.
So you're saying 42-35. How are they gonna get to that?
Yeah.
So it's gonna be four scores 28.
We can do math.
Gonna
guys,
get to
right?
gonna get
yes.
to gonna get to 35.
We're picking you guys up in
and
the
then
back
there's
there.
They're gonna get to 30. They're gonna get to no. That's six scores. It's six touchdowns.
You're right. No, you're right. You're right.
That is six
right.
touchdowns.
You're absolutely right.
Because this game is gonna be all about having to score touchdowns in order to keep up, basically. So it's gonna be six touchdowns.
Are we gonna see our first overtime Super Bowl?
No.
Is that gonna happen?
No.
That's my hope. I
yeah.
always hope that for every single Super Bowl.
I hope for that every year. See, I'm thinking, I'm going about this a little differently, I guess, than most of you guys. You're thinking it's going to be high scoring. I'm thinking it's actually going to be a low scoring game.
A defensive stalemate, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
But the defenses aren't that good, though.
You are probably the only person on the planet predicting that right now.
So, what,
so
do
yeah.
you have an idea of what...
I could win
what,
really big in Vegas right
yeah.
now.
Do you have an idea of what the score is going
to
be?
Do I have a score prediction? You know, it's hard to say. I think 2017.
Yeah. Okay.
And that's not, I guess that's not really
that's
that low score.
But for those teams,
yeah.
that's about half of what they score on a normal basis. So
yeah.
That's
I was thinking
low.
Something around like a 24-21 kind of
yeah.
game. Again, like something like that's kind of low.
Who
like,
do you
winner.
Think is going to win?
Falcons?
You think Falcons? I think the Patriots will win.
Okay.
But I don't. I'm not. Listen, I'm, this is a prediction, but I'm rooting for the Falcons today, and I don't know why I'm leaning back.
Do you think the game's going to come down to the last play?
No. I don't know. Yeah, I think probably. I would think that they would. In the fourth quarter. I don't know. This is just a prediction. Fourth quarter, Patriots have the lead. Maybe the Falcons get one more possession, and they fuck it up, and then Patriots win.
Okay.
And they kneel it, and.
actually.
But I know that's kind of anticlimactic, but sometimes that's just the way it goes.
But here's the thing, though. I predict that it's going to be Atlanta that gets out to such an early lead, and they carry that over to the third quarter. Because the fourth quarter, everyone knows, is Tom Brady's bread and butter. And he has come back from more... The Atlanta Falcons are going to come out with such force in the first three quarters that it's going to be a catch-up game. And that's what they have to do. They literally have to... They're going to have to wear out the defense even further. Because, like, the Patriots' defense is better than the Falcons' defense, but the Falcons' offense is so much better than the Patriots' offense.
Yeah. Well, I think you're right in that the Falcons will probably start off strong. And the Patriots have been really good at coming back and being huge disappointments.
But I don't want to see the Patriots win.
But the thing is, the Falcons do, I think their only chance is they do have to come out with an early lead. I think that's their only chance.
I'm imagining it's going to be big. There's going to be a lot of action going on in the very beginning, and then it's going to be very big at the end. I'm imagining like a slow middle end of the game.
Yeah. What about the halftime show?
Second and third quarter, I think, are going to be kind of like...
You know what?
Let's talk about the halftime show. How about Lady Gaga?
I think she's going to be good.
I really think she... I like Lady Gaga.
I really don't care. I hate the halftime show.
What are your odds on her singing Poker Face?
Of course she's going to sing Poker.
See, this is my issue with Lady Gaga. So she came out as Lady Gaga, you know, right after she did the whole, like, alt-rock sort of whatever, and then she was Lady Gaga. She was, like, the queen of synth-pop. And then she went back on it, and I'm like, you and I, was her going back to, like, her roots. And I'm like, no. I love the synth-pop. Keep being the queen of pop. Mm-hmm. I want to hear Poker Face. I want to hear Bad Romance. I want to hear Paparazzi. I don't want to hear Million Reasons. I don't want to hear You and I. That's just going to come up, but I don't want to hear that because you came to me as a pop person. I don't want to hear you going back on yourself because you're Lady Gaga.
Is there anybody supposed to be performing with her, or is it just her?
Maybe there'll be a surprise. Maybe the Red Hot Chili Peppers
will come out.
Oh, God.
wait.
It's going to be the Black Eyed Peas.
Does anyone have any prediction on who's going to be the surprise?
The Black Keys.
The Black Keys.
I'm just kidding.
They would be like the last people.
Probably the Black Eyed Peas.
The Black Eyed Peas.
Wait, did you say the Black Eyed Peas or the Black Keys?
Hold on. I'm going on the thousand to one here. I'm betting Hanson's gonna come out.
When we went to the Giants game, the Giants Cowboys game. Remember who the halftime show was?
I don't remember. It was at all.
I think I was with you. It was the Baja Men. The guys.
Oh yeah, that was us.
No one's seen those guys in like 20 years.
Yo, you know what that song's about? It's about letting ugly fat girls at a club.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who let the dogs out?
Well, they proudly sang it and jumped around with Giants jerseys on. It was a good time.
Any song that makes me millions of dollars, I don't care what.
You know what's
gonna
be?
That's true.
You know what the halftime show is going to be? They're going to completely psych us out. It's not even going to be Lady Gaga. It's going to be... It's going to be... NSYNC and Britney Spears and Aerosmith.
Like from the 2000s?
Oh, yeah. Bowl. They're bringing it back.
Oh, my gosh. All right. We'll see what happens, guys. I mean...
Well, I actually have British news.
Maybe there'll be a big scandal.
Mr. Bovine Joni is.
Only if it's in New Jersey. Okay.
Well, actually, where is the Super Bowl this year? Texas?
Houston. Yep. Houston.
Houston hasn't had any winning teams.
So we are unbiased and
100% unbiased.
We just favor the Falcons a little more.
Yeah.
We should talk about commercials, guys.
The Budweiser commercial.
I feel like this last year there weren't that many great commercials. There was nothing.
Last year it was kind of terrible.
I was really upset that there wasn't a Tim Tebow commercial about abortion.
Wasn't the TV in a different place next last year?
Yeah.
All right. Good. Yeah. Now that my spatial awareness
thank
is like,
God,
all of the
thank goodness you guys
listeners.
Know the TV is back in the place.
Because you can see the space.
Yeah.
Of course.
If you could see the space.
Couple big
it works a lot better.
Out.
I like how it's
year.
Right now. It's a little nicer.
By the way, we have a new
hello.
Streamins.
Streamin.
What's up?
Streamin' Steve Feldman.
Apparently Streamin'.
Dr. Streamin' Feldman.
We're losing a couple of big commercial players, though. Doritos is apparently not going to make an appearance.
Really?
Oh,
Doritos, and there was one more. I'm going to check. But but apparently $5 million for a 30-second spot was they finally...
Just too much for them?
Really?
Yeah.
I'm surprised. Doritos is always the big ass.
Yeah, Doritos always has the good ones.
How many Budweiser ads do you think they're going to be? And are they
going to
be funny? Are they going to be funny, though?
I think they're going to have a... Yeah.
Oh, is it? They're going to be like political stuff.
Yeah. I hear Nintendo's making an ad for the Super Bowl for the Switch. Yeah.
Ooh. Interesting.
We got another Madden game.
I'm trying to remember, but I think one of the funniest Budweiser commercials was a few years back. Cedric the Entertainer was in it, and essentially the ad was that he was going to get a few beers for himself and a lady friend, and as he's grabbing them, he's dancing around.
Yeah.
And he gets back into the living room, but all his dancing shook up the beers, so when he opens it up, it just goes all over this
female.
That was a good commercial, but do you realize that's from like 15 years ago? That's not a few years ago. That's a long
time
ago.
Wow, I feel old now.
Yeah,
we need another Michael Jordan and Larry Bird McDonald's commercial.
Other than Barbershop 3, what is Cedric the Entertainer really about these days? Which is sad, because he's funny.
He just came out with a new special, stand-up special.
Is it on Netflix?
I don't know where it is. I just know he did it.
Sorry, if it's not on Netflix, I don't know where it is.
I honestly didn't know he was still doing stuff.
He's hysterical.
He's an entertainer.
He's funny, but he was funny for 5 minutes in the 90s.
He's still funny. It's like when people say that Cat Williams is the final baker. Excuse me. Cat Williams is hysterical. You just have to like really get on to it. Ken Davey doesn't like Cat Williams.
What?
I have no opinion on Cat Williams.
Yeah, me neither.
I love Cat Williams. He's hysterical because he sweats constantly.
I honestly don't know his stuff well enough to really know. I haven't watched.
He doesn't have what you would call iconic bits, but he also is just generally funny and says it the way it's supposed to be said.
I mean, he's very popular, so I would assume.
And that's the podcast.
We gotta go. The cops are here.
I would assume that Cat Williams is decent enough. He sells out big theaters.
He also says motherfucker like nobody else.
Yeah.
He goes, motherfucker!
Yeah. So, this goes back to my background a little bit, but I hear Bill Nye the Science Guy is making an appearance in a Super Bowl commercial this year.
Is that right?
That's going to be good.
You know Bill Nye is from Rochester, New York?
Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Is he really?
Yeah, he's from Rochester, New York. He used to dance when he was on Dancing with the Stars. He used to dance in the dancing studio I used to play at every Wednesday, but the band folded because they didn't want to pay us anymore. But like Bill Nye used to come over because his like girlfriend was like really important. He was on Dancing with the Stars.
Bill Nye was on Dancing with the Stars.
Yeah,
he was also a part of model during Fashion Week.
I saw that.
It was glorious.
So I literally got to like vomit my like self love for Bill Nye, and he was really nice about it. I was like, you made me love science. He's like, it's fine.
All right.
So we're going to see Bill Nye tonight.
Yes.
Hooray.
Very cool. And, you know, I'm trying to think of the last funny commercial that I remember, because I don't remember anything from last year.
Yeah, no.
A few years ago, I loved the Darth Vader kid. Do you remember
that?
That's
a good one.
Yes. I think it was some car company, maybe Kia.
Okay.
It was Volkswagen. Oh, very good.
There you go.
We have Anya in the back. And that was the best one.
That was good. I remember a few, maybe, this was definitely like 2 or 3 years ago. It was a Doritos commercial where, I don't know, I guess the guy was taunting a dog.
Yeah.
It was like a little like bulldog, and then he just jumps through the glass front door to like get the Doritos.
There was a similar, I think it was similar commercial, I think it was last year, where the man's in the delivery room with the mother, you know, she has the baby, they're doing the ultrasound, and he has the Dorito, and as he moves it, he sees the baby on the ultrasound moving towards the Dorito, and he's like, oof, 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 and then he throws the Dorito, and then all of a sudden, you see the baby on the ultrasound, and she goes, and like, fly out of the mom's like, That one was awesome.
You know, speaking of babies, I hope there's no talking babies,
because
I'm so sick of talking baby commercials.
I remember those.
Or just any talk, like, or talking animals.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the E-Trade babies. Like, I'm so sick.
Someone listening to this now, next couple of days shaking their head because it's probably going to happen.
It's probably...
You must have been real disappointed.
Yeah, it's probably just a series of E-Trade baby commercials. Oh, like,
we're bringing them back. Ah, babies that talk. It's funny.
Yeah, like, that stuff...
How's your investment portfolio?
It's hilarious.
Teach their own, but, like, talking babies, talking animals, like, it's just not funny.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
They typically always throw both the Bud Light and the Budweiser where they have the horses.
I presume at least one of those, right?
Yes.
And at least one with a dog.
The Clydesdales are kind of...
Yeah.
It's classic.
This happens every year.
Yeah.
It's like the Coca-Cola commercials with the polar bears.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yo, but when they have the polar bears and the penguins in the same commercials, like, you realize that they're two different hemispheres.
Now, does Coke...
And in real life, the situation goes very differently.
Does Coke typically do the Super Bowl commercials, or is it Pepsi that does the Super Bowl commercials?
Pepsi,
right?
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay.
I didn't know that, actually. I thought...
Yeah. But they haven't really done it too much lately. There was more of, like, a late 90s, early 2000s.
Yeah.
When they had, like, Britney Spears. Like,
yeah.
My favorite... I
don't remember. I'm not sure.
I guess
they might throw in one.
I can't remember, actually, a Coca-Cola commercial.
My favorite Pepsi commercial, and this was... Not even a Super Bowl commercial, but my favorite was when this mosquito, like, came and drank a drop of, like, the Pepsi and then started singing, like, Mick Jagger and sang Brown Sugar. And that was my introduction when I was, like, 6 years old to the Rolling Stones. And my dad, like, took me aside and was like, I have to teach you so much. And then I became a Rolling Stones fan from, like, that day on.
Oh, look
and
at that.
Was like,
good job, Pepsi.
Yeah. You made a Rolling Stones fan with a animatronic...
And now he's
it's all they can hope for. Is making
famous
more
musician.
Rolling Stones
where you are
fans.
Now.
Who do we think is going to be the MVP?
Oh, that's a very good question.
Matt Ryan.
I'm going to say it as a Jets fan. I don't want it to happen, but there is a certain amount of satisfaction that comes with the idea of watching Roger Goodell have to hand Tom Brady the Super Bowl trophy. I don't want to see it happen. But after last 2 years and all this Deflategate nonsense, I would want nothing more than to watch that happen. Just because he's just handled it so terribly and he's being such a big baby about it. He hasn't been to Foxborough in 2 years. He's the commissioner and he hasn't visited one of his teams.
Yeah.
Roger Goodell literally is like he is the Trump of sports.
He is.
Let's get political for a second. Are we allowed to?
We're allowed to. We try not to.
Pardon me. Let me take that back.
No, it's fine. I think what we can say though is that no matter what your political affiliation, everyone hates that guy.
Everybody hates Goodell.
He's mishandled all of these abuse cases. Like, are you kidding me? You can't knock your wife out and then be like, oh, no, you're only suspended for 3 games. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
What was it? Originally, Ray Rice was suspended for 2 and only became an indefinite thing because basically everyone flipped out and was like, really?
And
it's not like it's up for debate. Well, there's video of it.
Because he was clearly hiding the tape for a long time.
Yeah.
He was like, make sure this doesn't get out. And he was probably paying someone
off. Like, and the fact they actually don't, like, publish studies that, like, former football players who have head injuries are more likely to be violent. Like, that's just gross. Like, are you kidding me? Like, there's, like, Junior Seau committed suicide because he had a ton of head injuries and was an alcoholic after he retired. And that's a direct link to that, but they won't publish those. And they, and, you know, of course, they're trying to make everything safer with all the helmets and all the gear. But I was like, no. Like, you realize that you are putting people in the way of danger, that everyone's flying around here at the top of, like, their athletic peak at 200-something pounds. And hitting people in the head. People get injured and people get hurt. Like, they need to do way more to help that stuff. Because if you guys, I don't know if you guys have ever looked into it, but, like, there's players that get, like, paralyzed on the practice squad and then they're screwed over the rest of life.
Oh, yeah. Well, the lifespan of an NFL player is, like, it's ridiculously short.
Totally. And it's like, they need to do way more for the healthcare. If they're going to be a non-tax organization, they need to help their players a lot more, especially post.
Absolutely. Well, I think
that's super important.
I think we're going to see in years to come. The game is going to change a lot, and they're going to, and, you know, with all the research that they're doing.
I really hope so, because it is. But
for better or for worse, I mean, I don't know what it's going to look like.
But it's like every rule they make, like to save players in one way, they're like costing them another. Like, you know, you're not allowed to hit players in the head. All helmet to helmet contact is done. So no one, you know, goes up top. Now they go low and they take out everyone's ACL is blown or MCL, you know, or like their knees are just terrible.
What do you think about no helmets, less padding? In order to avoid... Some people think that would avoid some of it because they wouldn't go... Because you have the helmets, they think helmet to helmet, you're going to be okay. But they don't realize you have your head is inside that helmet and it's not going to be okay.
But things also happen too, right? Like, you can say that and it would certainly motivate players to avoid it because there's less or no protection up there. Mm-hmm. But you're on the field. I mean, we see the game from our perspective and the stands are on TV, but we don't see it from their perspective. Sometimes things just happen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's never going to be a scenario where there's going to be no helmet-to-helmet contact.
You're talking about people that have been trained to do one thing since the time they were in middle school and went to a full-ride college and then are now getting paid millions of dollars. Their job is to be as athletically fit as possible, and like their adrenal glands are going crazy. So of course, at the moment, we can be like, "Oh, you should have gone head to head," but it's like that you're taught just to fucking tackle somebody.
Yeah, it's really tough, and it's a lot of times people move at the last second when you're lined up for a tackle.
There's only so much you can do.
You can't stare at the person the whole time. You have to, you know, protect yourself and duck your head and, you know, go for the wrap or whatever. And you know, sometimes they duck into it, and then you have helmet to helmet, you know. Mm. And then just, like, the whole removing helmets things. Look at how many times, you know, incidental contact. Like, people would, or just receivers going up for catches, you know, and falling and smacking their heads on the ground.
I really don't think that's going to happen.
No.
Getting rid of helmet. It's something that, you know, they talk about, but it's not taken
really
seriously.
It won't happen because just the nature of the game, your head's going to hit something eventually. People running at top speed. And like we were saying before, you have a lot more players getting their ACLs taken out. And you saw that this year with just the sheer volume of quarterback injuries that are happening where they're getting... No, their heads aren't getting hurt, but like you have quarterbacks that are blowing out their knees, tearing out their ACLs.
Yeah,
Teddy Bridgewater might miss the entire 2017 season, too.
And Teddy Bridgewater was a decent quarterback.
Yep. He was.
He may never play again.
Derek Carr made me really upset because Oakland was a good team.
Oakland was so upsetting. I really liked Oakland. That was going to be the Patriots this year.
Yeah.
That was the team that was going
to
be
the Patriots. I really believe they had the best chance, at least in the AFC.
Yeah, definitely.
They had the best chance, but you compare the Patriots to the rest of the AFC, and there was almost no possibility that anyone besides the Patriots were going to represent
them. Belichick is a wild card this year. He figures out how to do it. He figures out how to win.
They were just so far. They're so far in a class of their own.
He cheats.
Yeah.
Hey, they flew a drone over the Atlanta practice. There was a drone.
Is that true?
Yep.
He didn't, but there was a drone.
There was a drone.
Belichick sitting behind the controls.
There was a drone.
The offensive coordinator's on Atlanta's playbook was still like misplaced for about.
I heard that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I guess
people are always gonna.
You guys know a lot more
like
than
this.
We do at this point.
So
maybe there was a disaster. Maybe when did the lights go out? When did the power go out?
That was
2013.
That was your old place, right?
That was 2013, because we were in our old apartment.
Yeah. Was that the year we had the dual room?
So this was 4 years ago, and we had the two TV setup.
Awesome.
That was Ravens
Niners.
There was
about 35 people over too.
There was a ton of people over. Thank God we had the two TV setup.
So who knows? Maybe there's going to be another like blackout or some sort of big event. Let us know what that event is. Write it into, like, send it to us. Be like, you guys guessed wrong. Yeah, you guys guessed wrong. This thing actually happened.
Do we have any predictions we want to put out there for, like, any kind of, like, because there's always some kind of scandal at the Super Bowl.
Right? Yeah.
You know, Beyonce was last year?
Beyonce was last year. I think the scandal?
Well, she came out.
There was a lot of discussion that her performance was based on, basically a Black Lives Matter statement, which it almost certainly was. And on that same train of thought, I'm going to make for the obvious likely scandals that Lady Gaga is going to make some sort of statement against President Trump.
Sure.
And I think that's almost, it almost has to happen. Like, there's very little chance it doesn't happen.
I think if anything, she might wear something.
Well,
A meat suit.
A meat suit.
She doesn't really seem to do that too much anymore.
Is there going to be? I don't know if it's still going on. The kneeling for the national anthem. Is that still going on?
I don't think these teams do that.
Right.
I don't think. I know Seattle. They lock arms. That's their thing.
Okay.
I do think it's still going on. I just think the media just stopped paying attention to
right,
it.
Right.
Because it was a whole thing with Kaepernick, and then a bunch of other players start doing it, and then everyone stopped caring,
they were doing the specifics, but you...
But not as many teams were doing it as you would think.
Yeah.
It was definitely minority. It just got a very large...
few players, and I know the Dolphins... some of the players on the Dolphins did it, but I know the... I certainly know the Giants didn't do it. I know the Patriots.
Do you guys anticipate any, like... Odell Beckham type catches, one-handed.
Julio Jones. Like,
I predict a Julio Jones 75-yard touchdown.
Oh, that would be great. That would be so
smart,
cool.
They'll try and catch the ball with two hands.
Well, yes.
Because Odell tries to show off too much.
That is
and I
true.
I could go off about that.
And how's that working out for him?
It's not working out. This is actually it was the worst thing he ever did was do that one-handed catch.
Yeah.
I also predict Tom Brady will be spotted on camera crying at one point.
Yes.
Whether it's to the referees, or after the game, or for some reason, there will be tears in his eyes.
Will Martellus Bennett be dancing with cheerleaders again? He did at the end of the championship one.
Do you remember, what was it? Was
Let's
it,
hope not.
Was it last year or the year before that Peyton was in the Super Bowl, and there was the footage last year. And then they show the footage of Eli up in the stands with like his weird Eli face.
Yeah.
Oh, he just, everyone else is cheering and jumping wildly, and he just had his blank stare.
Yeah,
like,
which he later, claimed that he was like just, he had his mind in the zone of the game.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
He was just trying to pick, he was like, oh, how would I approach these situations? Kind of deal. Not necessarily like,
Eli's a class act.
And to be fair, that's usually what he looks like.
Well,
anyway.
Yeah, that's his normal face, so.
Well, it was also the moment his brother now has two Super Bowls as well, so the one thing he had over him.
Yeah, but last year was depressing, though. Peyton couldn't do shit.
Still, though,
he won.
Yeah.
The Broncos won. He retired on top.
He got a second Super Bowl. That's like the place kick holder who has four Super Bowl rings. It's like,
you know who also did that? The great Michael Strahan.
And he
went on to have a great post career.
Peyton Manning is really good with those commercials.
I'm so sick of those commercials.
Yeah.
But we're probably going to see one of those.
Oh, we're definitely going to see one of those.
No question about it.
Absolutely.
You will see Peyton Manning eating
a
sandwich.
He's going to be on... There's going to be a commercial with Peyton Manning sitting on the couch watching the Super Bowl.
I bet you Favre is going to be there.
Yeah?
Favre?
Yeah.
Favre.
He's definitely going to be part of that.
Can't stand that guy.
Why?
Because he came to the Jets and was just terrible.
Yeah.
He was good for a few weeks, and then he just had no interest in playing for the Jets.
You should stop hating the Steelers so much because Joe Namath came from Pittsburgh, so you should calm down.
Yeah, but he was on the Jets.
Yeah,
I have a problem with the Steelers.
We have two Jets fans here, both wearing Mark Sanchez jerseys.
Mark Sanchez, hot dog.
And sitting across, we have one Steelers fan. So that's where this comes
from.
He's also wearing green and white.
That is true.
Gen Z beer. This is also Kelly Green. Get your forest green out of here. This is Kelly Green.
Hey, you got your forest green right
green
here.
Is
hey.
Green. All right, colorblind. No. Joe Namath came from Pittsburgh. My dad went to high school with Joe Namath.
Oh.
All the greatest...
Never heard that story before.
All the greatest quarterbacks came from Pittsburgh area. Dan Marino is from Pittsburgh. Joe Montana from Pittsburgh.
Greatest quarterback to never win anything. Dan Marino.
That's true.
Do we have any other predictions that we want to throw out there? We're talking about commercials.
Yeah.
We're talking about scandals. We're talking about all the things that are going on around the actual game. And that's
kind of
what the Super Bowl has become. It's
actually,
like, everyone's talking about everything else. The game is secondary.
The game is truly secondary.
I bet you there's
going to
be some touchdowns.
I bet you there's going to be a streaker. I think this year there's going to be a streaker.
There's going to be a streaker.
Because, look.
Are you predicting
like
it's going to be you?
Are you specifying that it's going to be at the game, or there's just going to be a streaker somewhere in the world?
No, there's going to be a streaker.
You can be in the stadium.
I feel like it's going to be this year that there's going to be a streaker. Or somebody else is going to... I feel like this is a year where shit's just going to go wrong at the Super Bowl.
I do think there will be something political. Whether it be like Lady Gaga or maybe there'll be a commercial.
It would be great if Lady Gaga came out in like orange face
That would be, like, amazing.
She just came out dressed as, and just did, like,
as a Cheeto?
Donald Trump impression.
Orange lines.
See, that would be a funny halftime show.
Yeah, right?
That would be a fun one. I would
honestly,
pay attention to it.
She
would
have
be
to save her career either. She already has more money than God. She can buy, like, 7 private islands all to fart on. Like, she literally could come out, dress as Donald Trump, and do an entire halftime show.
You heard it here first. Lady Gaga, buy a bunch of islands
she,
and fart on them.
She
this
could
is my
come
island.
Onto the stage.
I just go here to fart.
She could come onto the stage, take a shit, and leave, and she would still be fine for the rest of her life.
Yep.
It literally doesn't matter.
Yeah.
So she's going to go for it.
Part of me's hoping something's going to happen like that, because I've only been ever bored by the halftime shows. Like, just...
Except when Prince did it.
Oh, Prince is great.
What
or
was
the
that?
Rolling Stones.
That
R.I.P.
was a while ago.
That was a good few years.
R.I.P. Prince.
That was a while ago.
R.I.P. No, that was Prince was 2006.
It was a while back.
No,
like 06,
was that long
07.
Ago?
Yeah,
really?
That was that long ago.
Yeah.
Wow. And it just started raining.
And he still
like,
did purple. And
it
did purple rain. Oh, yeah. My favorites.
Oh, I heard. Oh, by the way, I actually just watched something on this the other day about Prince doing that thing. Because, you know, apparently the stage was quite slick to begin with, and then it started raining, so it was super, you know, super slick. Mm-hmm. And the people from the NFL, you know, they're like, oh, it's supposed to rain that day. And then it started raining, and they called up Prince, and they're like, are you okay with still performing in the rain? And Prince said, can you make it rain harder?
Yes!
And it was like,
yes!
What a great response.
Yeah. Actually... I would want everyone in this crowd as well as like whoever's listening. You have to go back and actually rewatch that halftime show because it's up on YouTube, and they have the entire halftime show, and it is really powerful. I mean, obviously, rest in peace, Prince is dead. That's like super freaking
just
sad.
Just about a year now, right?
Yep, just about a year.
Yeah.
Freaking sad, but like that halftime show stands out from pretty much every halftime show besides the Janet Jackson food incident. Like, really.
Yeah, the Janet Jackson thing now...
Nipgate.
By today's standards, it doesn't seem like a big deal
at
all anymore.
At the time, it truly wasn't a big deal. I think it just got blown out of proportion. Well, she fell out of her top. Who cares?
Well, I guess
she
we were.
Didn't fall
I was like
out
13.
Of her top. Justin Timbertape
ripped it.
Timberlake ripped it all.
Timbertape.
So when that happened, that was a long time.
That
ago.
That was a long time ago.
I think I was like 13.
Yeah,
I was
still
in middle school, and I very specifically remember this. And the only reason I remember this happened was because the very first thing that happened. The day after was one of my friends came into school and just screamed at the top of his lungs, Janet Jackson's boobie, and then walked away.
Well, I was at my friend's place, and he was one of the first people I knew who had TiVo.
Oh,
TiVo
okay.
was like had just become a thing. And
back in the day.
Yeah, and for those of you who don't know what TiVo is, it's DVR. Basically,
yeah,
but it was
recording.
Before DVR,
right? So
DVR before DVR.
So when it happened so quickly that I missed it.
Oh,
and but he saw it and he was like, "What?" And he goes and he rewinds it and just kept rewinding it and showing it to everybody.
Yeah, I remember it, and honestly, it had to have been staged, and I think it just got blown out of proportion. Like,
well,
it didn't
was,
have the
it
reaction.
Was
it was the only nipple with. The
it,
nipple ring.
It had a pasty.
It was star.
She had
was
a pasty.
It sun
nobody
shape.
Nobody just
no.
puts a pasty on their.
Why?
No,
it
wasn't
a
pasty.
That was
no,
not a pasty.
No.
That looked like a pasty.
No, it was a nipple
no, it
ring
was,
that
it
went through
it
the center
stunt.
And it was
a
sun for
the
shape
shape
of a
story.
Star.
Word?
Yeah.
Because
she was a nobody until. She, I mean, no,
she
no,
was
she
a nobody. She was Janet Jackson.
She was Janet Jackson. But she, her career was falling off.
But she was a
and
nobody.
And then they brought the hottest guy at the time to do the thing and then did that completely. Like, and then her shit went off. It was completely...
She was already a huge star, though, for a long time.
Really?
No, but, like, we're also talking... This happened in, what, 2000 and...
But, like,
four?
Come on.
Like,
around that.
And Janet Jackson was kind of on the downslope, and this was a big political move, and she did it.
I can see that. I mean...
But it was that...
I don't know.
I was always surprised, though, that Justin
we're
Timberlake...
We're not looking at appropriate things.
I was always surprised Justin Timberlake never got into any trouble for that. They never mentioned him.
Yeah,
thing.
It was only her.
Yeah.
Definitely her.
Because
yeah.
the media demonizes women.
Well,
facts.
Yeah.
Sorry. Facts.
We're getting political.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry. I'm already. Sorry.
I'm just kidding. I'm
no,
kidding.
No. I'm sorry. I've been so politically charged.
I think it had to
have
been
like,
staged, dude.
100%.
It's 100% staged, so that has
everything.
Though. I think it was just people
tough.
Took it the wrong way.
Yeah. So
just think, who cares? It's
yeah.
not
it,
a big
why don't
deal.
We steer back
it's
to
not
this,
that
this
big
Super
deal.
Bowl?
Yeah. So this Super Bowl.
All right. So we have our predictions. Did everyone give their score predictions?
No. So all right, score prediction, Streven.
All right, so I'm
Streven, Steve.
I'm more inclined to go in Andrew's direction that it's going to be a high scoring game. I'm not going to go as high scoring as him. I do think we're probably looking at something along the lines of maybe a 35-31 or something along those lines, something closer to what we saw
in favor of
in favor of the Patriots, most likely. Truthfully, I hate to make the prediction.
Yeah.
Fuck the Patriots.
But the Patriots have just been. There's just haven't been a team as good as Patriots this year. There just has not been. I mean, they went 3-1 without Tom Brady, and after he came back, they lost one other. They only lost one other game. I'm giving predictions here, guys.
Sorry, I'm distracting Andrew.
And who do they even lose to? They lost that one game to the Bills when they didn't have Tom Brady. They're on like their third string quarterback who was also injured at the time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's a tough one to even consider. Who else did the Patriots lose to this year?
I'm not sure. That,
they
that's
three losses.
To look up.
They lost
randomly to a team that sucked.
They finished 14-2.
That's very specific.
I'm 14-3.
Lost 3 times.
14.
Well,
you can't win
14
games.
There's only 16 games.
13-3. I'm looking it up right now.
They were very good. Well, let's keep going. While you do that,
anyway,
let's go on predictions.
I mentioned it was. I believe it's going to be. Like lower scoring of 24-21 Falcons.
24-21 Falcons. And I said 20-17 in favor of the Patriots, and I'm going to stick with that.
I'm being optimistic.
And just to jump back in for a moment, they did lose Week 10 to the Seahawks, 31-24.
Okay.
So and Seattle's a good team, but they're
very
still.
Good.
But even they're still not. They're not as good as they were in the last few years, and they're not. Patriots quarterback.
That,
I mean,
Pete Carroll's a piece of shit.
I mean,
was
it's not
in
like
Seattle though. Was that game in Seattle?
That was in New England. Actually,
oh, interesting. Okay.
Interestingly enough, the two games they lost were both in Foxborough.
Huh.
But a lot of the games that they won
got shut out.
Shut out by the Bills again. Remember though, Tom Brady suspended. You had Garoppolo, and I don't remember the name of their third stringer, but they were both hurt.
Oh, Garoppolo.
That was Garoppolo.
No.
Sorry, whatever.
Garoppolo.
Garoppolo. Whatever.
He was good.
He did fine in Tom Brady's absence, and he was injured though. Their third stringer was injured.
No Gronk right now.
No Gronk.
But
Gronk fucks his backup.
I think as good as Atlanta is, I also think Atlanta is a very hot and cold team, and I just have a hard time seeing. As a Jets fan, I hope they win because I do enjoy seeing Tom Brady cry.
Yeah.
But speaking as a football fan, I'm going 35-31 Patriots.
Okay. What did you have?
Rando.
My prediction. For the final score, I also think that Atlanta is going to win.
Yes.
I think the final score is going to be 35-27.
35-27.
And Kendra, and 8 points.
I'm just drinking my
Make a guess. All
right.
Just
make
put
a
up
guess.
Numbers. Put up numbers.
Just say two numbers.
And what, Ethan, what
I,
was your
I feel on the spot. Let me think about it.
Yeah, think about it.
You had 42, Andrew. You had 42-35.
I had 42-35 because it's going to be a very high scoring game because they're both not very good defenses. Neither of them were top five.
Not true though.
It
Patriots have a very good defense.
No, and
the
Falcons defense is surprisingly good.
You saw what they did to Green Bay.
So
that's
what I'm saying though. Like we're talking two non-top five defenses overall. But in the playoffs, they both got better. And the Falcons' defense, I think, is going to surprise everybody because they were able to dismantle Green Bay, which I thought was going to be the unstoppable
like
machine.
That was pretty pathetic.
It's difficult to make Aaron Rodgers look that uncomfortable.
He looked terrible.
So, and I actually put Aaron Rodgers in the same class as Tom Brady when it comes to that silent quarterback.
Absolutely.
And the thing is, like Aaron Rodgers, when Tom Brady gets flustered, you know, he starts bitching to the refs so bad, and then it gets in his mind, and he doesn't play as good. And that's exactly what happened in the Houston game. And if Atlanta can get to Tom Brady,
then I think that changes.
Oh, Matt Ryan is such a young quarterback.
They gotta get into his head.
He's not that young anymore. 27? 4 years in the league?
He's sitting in his late 20s, I'm pretty sure.
No, he's at least like 6 years.
Okay, so here's what's going to happen. It's going to take at least a quarter for Atlanta to settle in, because you are going to the Super Bowl. Like, this is what you go to college for football for. So once Atlanta actually finds its grounding, they're going to light up the scoreboard, because Atlanta is the most explosive offense. I mean, they're the number one offense all year. I mean, they're after watching the game against Green Bay, I had to stop. I had to put on mute because, like, this is a massacre. Mm-hmm. And Green Bay has a good defense. I mean, everybody that Atlanta has come up against they're that good. So I feel like it's going to have to be a game of the veteran versus, it's like the old Sith versus the new Sith. And it's like, whoever is gonna come out has to cement their game and then execute it. Because when Tom Brady gets in his groove, nobody's better than Tom Brady. But when Atlanta gets in their groove of offense, nobody is better than Atlanta. So it's about who's going to get there first and also who's going to disrupt on defense. So I still think it's going to be Atlanta, because I think Atlanta has a better offense than the Patriots.
And like I said before, I think Atlanta needs to come out with a big lead.
Yeah.
So I think that's their only chance.
They have to have the first three quarters, they have to dominate it and then let the Patriots try to play.
I think the key is they got to get into Brady's head. If you can get into Brady's head, then you can dominate.
Because we've seen that happen before. Yeah. Both times the Patriots played the Giants in the Super Bowl, you saw, especially I think the second time around.
Oh, yeah.
Now we're coming in 4 years after the Giants ruined their potential perfect season in 2007 and 2008.
Mm-hmm.
Now you have them playing again, and I think you saw a lot of that Tom Brady was off his game because it was in his head, oh my God, this team that did it last time, oh my God, it's happening again. It was another close game. It was like 24-21 or... It was
close. 1 year it was 17-14.
17-14 was, that was 2000, that was Super Bowl 42.
I think that was the first one.
But let's also be real here. That Giants defensive line
was the best.
I mean, they incredible.
They were that
incredible. Piece. When you have Michael Strahan on one side and then
OC,
it's just like,
Do you think going into the game, even before the Falcons are doing anything, do you think Tom Brady's probably going to have some sort of thing going on in his head, in that the last few times they've been to the Super Bowl, they blew it?
No, because he won 2 years ago.
Yeah.
So. All right.
Remember,
fair enough.
Yeah,
That's true.
They did beat Seattle, but at the same time, they beat truly, the Patriots did not beat Seattle. Seattle beat themselves.
That's true.
Yeah. Seattle beat Seattle.
Pete Carroll beat Seattle. That's why he's a piece of crap.
That's true.
You have one of the best goal line running backs in the history of the league, and on fourth and one.
Second and one. You have arguably the best running back.
Beast mode.
Also,
beast mode. I
love Marshawn Lynch, and I think he should have his own reality show.
Oh, yeah.
Because,
I don't know when he's on Conan?
I would watch
when he's on Conan, but he was also...
I know that name.
He was also in this video recently where he's in Scotland.
Okay.
And he's giving out Skittles to people.
That's awesome.
He's obviously...
That sounds great.
And it's really funny.
I could watch... Like, hours of just Marshawn Lynch just giving people Skittles.
Yeah. By the
way, that sounds great.
I love how Marshawn Lynch eats Skittles on the sideline. It's hilarious. And, like, well, and Mark Sanchez has a hot dog on the sideline. And everyone, the whole world,
no,
like, comes in and,
he looks so sad because he's eating
hot dogs. Oh, this hot dog. Poor Mark Sanchez.
Man,
I still believe he caught a bad rap.
He needs
rap.
A hug.
Yes.
I really do think the Jets were
you know what? He should go out to the Chargers. Because the Chargers should get rid of Phillip Rivers, because fuck that whole franchise.
You mean the Los Angeles Chargers?
LOL.
Is it the Chargers or the Dodgers? I can't remember.
I don't know. Based on their logo, it's hard to tell. All
right, so I got the sign that there's a wrapping up method.
Well,
so
we're not exactly right now, but we're coming towards it.
Yeah, not
so
really. I mean, we just want to get everything out there.
Yeah,
let's
do that. Because
we have our predictions.
Right.
You know, you guys are all. Oh, Steve, you think the Patriots. You and me think the Patriots.
We have a pretty split group here.
I will say that none of us here want the Patriots to win.
No.
Right.
That's the thing. And for
no,
various,
truly, I hope I'm wrong.
For various reasons, because you guys are Jets fans. I mean, I have no reason, because I'm a Giants fan and we beat the Patriots twice.
Nice.
I have no issue with them. But at the same time, I always root for the underdog. So
yeah,
therefore, I'm going to root for Atlanta.
They cheat, though.
Well, I mean, how big would this be? I mean, I think I was looking up. This is their this. If they won, this would be their first Super Bowl win.
Atlanta also.
So
Atlanta
that'd be
actually.
Huge.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
That'd be great.
In
be cool
all the, in all the time, the city of Atlanta has had professional teams. They only have one title. Period. And like Cleveland gets all the attention of having such a huge title drought.
Mm-hmm.
But 1995, the Atlanta Braves won the World Series, and that is that's it. The Falcons have never won anything.
They're
various hockey teams that no longer exist never won anything.
The Hawks
have
nothing.
I mean, self-explanatory on its own, right? So for the city of Atlanta,
you realize that like this isn't like the West Coast where no one gives a shit about like their teams except if they're baseball or basketball. Like Atlanta actually really cares about the sport teams that comes in. Like I know a ton of people from Atlanta that all moved up to like New York.
Atlanta's a good town. I like Atlanta.
Why would anyone do that? They're just like super.
I actually know a few people did the same thing.
They're like super into like their teams, even when their hockey teams come and go. It's like sad because like I believe that everyone should have hockey because hockey is.
Atlanta had a hockey team.
Two hockey teams. The Calgary. Oh my god, Calgary Flames. I'm drunk apparently. I'm not. That's the sad part.
They were the Atlanta Flames.
They were first the Atlanta Flames. Yep. They moved out. I don't remember when, but
they
a
were
while
the Calgary
ago.
Flames before, and then they moved to Atlanta, and then moved.
They moved. Did they really? They moved twice? Okay,
moved
that
twice.
Part I didn't know.
Wasn't
this the 70s?
90s.
But then Atlanta got... What were they
called? The Hawks.
They got the Atlanta...
They got like another hawk, like another bird. They were the Flames or some shit like that.
No, they weren't the Flames. They were something else. They're expanded, the one that moved to Winnipeg.
Oh, the like
sure.
Thrush or like the Rush?
Thrashers. Atlanta Thrashers. There
that's
it is.
It, the
they got the Atlanta Thrashers in the 90s. They played there, I think, for 19 years, and then they moved to Winnipeg.
And then,
well,
of course, they like in Winnipeg because it's Canada and hockey.
But no one, it's just not a hockey town. For obvious,
no.
It's just not at all.
It's a baseball, football, and basketball town.
I would say more than anything from... I've been there a few times. More than anything, it's I mean, sure, now it's a football town.
No,
I'm sure everyone's going for it.
No,
but
it is a baseball town. Just like Pittsburgh is always been a baseball and football town, and up until Mary Lemieux came in the 90s, it was not a hockey town, and now it's a hockey town.
Right. I mean, naturally, your city is going to follow your teams that are playing well more.
Yeah.
For obvious reasons, you know? Like
also,
you
go Penguins. All right, we can wrap
so
up.
So essentially,
we're going to do a hockey podcast
Sprouts.
Soon.
Yeah.
Sure. We'll have you guys Sprouts. On, we'll do some hockey.
Essentially,
stuff.
We're all rooting for Atlanta.
Yeah.
Regardless of whether or not we think the eventual outcome will be, but we all want Atlanta to win.
Thank you,
America. We're gonna get some Super Bowl food that's cooking.
Thank you, section for letting me be stupid.
You're welcome.
This was fun, guys, and you know you already know the outcome.
Yeah, tell us what we got right and wrong. Because
we won't know
because we're just gonna go to sleep after this.
Yeah, when I'm a genius because of my prediction, you're gonna have to have me on all week.
Uh oh.
Know.
I hope he's wrong. No.
We should have a bet going on what we said. We're using same as we did last night, Jeopardy rules.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We should closest to the actual score without going over.
Jeopardy? You mean Price is Right.
Price is Right rules? Sorry. I'm having
kind of wondering. How much have you drank?
Alright.
We had brunch.
Do we have anything else? Anything else that
branched.
We want to add?
We branched.
I think that's it. I think we covered everything we want to cover.
Okay. Great. Well, thanks guys for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And thank you for listening, and see you later.
Peace.